Hello, Victor Nygren is here. I'm back. Or Mr. Nygren. Alright, I'm playing Total War 1942. The game crashed when the loading screen finished. Last time I replayed the battle, same result. But I believe it went a little worse, but we still won, and most of the Soviet infantry died, and some of the tanks and the rest fled. Alright, man of the hour. Because we won, and we had a rifleman unit without the generals, and a new general, Gottfried Galen. Alright. Lost a few troops in the battle as well. This army will move up to the other one. And we will reinforce the army. They can't move there. Right, let's move this unit there. And the infantry. And the general. Lead that force. So. Could fight another battle immediately, actually. Save the game first. This Soviet army is led by Georgi Strukov, real general. We have some Katyushas here. Alright. Still going to fight it. Before the defeated army that ran away is reinforcing it. We don't want any of that. So, Georgi Strukov, their full army, one unit of MS-1 tanks, one unit of T-34, two units of Jak-9 planes, so they are equal in planes, I guess. They have lots of infantry as well, but we have tanks, they have Katyusha rockets, they are not to be underestimated. And they have a general, let's see what Strukov have as a bodyguard, an armored officer's car, alright. I believe we have the superior force, but those Katyusha rockets are very good. They were nerfed compared to in the early version, but they might still be good. Alright, let's start the battle. This war is a new kind of war. This warfare in terms of every continent, every island, every sea, every air lane in the world. Franklin D. Roosevelt, 23rd February 1942. And start deployment immediately. We have 13 riflemen left. It went worse, the last battle, for our own troop. Our own force, they fled the battle. Only 13 survived. Alright, loose formation and guard. They won't move, they will just stand there waiting on the Soviets to arrive. Alright, we have reinforcements, two armies of reinforcements. They have Jak-9 planes, two units, lots of different infantry troops here. And they have the deadly Katyusha rockets and one out of both the early tanks, T-34s and MS-1s. Now the question is, will they retreat or will they fight? I'm not sure. They have planes now. They have a lot of infantry as well. Our planes are soon about to fire on them. Messerschmitt here. Soon upon them. Yeah, they are firing at them now. The Katyusha rockets are firing, and they can fire while they are moving as well. Deadly rockets are fired from those trucks. Might actually take down the planes if we're unlucky here. before the rest of the army can arrive. One of the planes went down. They are really good, that unit. Alright. Another plane went down. Look at their trucks here, they can't use their rockets. Rocket trucks. Their planes have arrived as well. Our army is about to face off against their army soon. We have more armor this time. They have two units of Katyusha rocket trucks that might actually prove more deadly if you're unlucky. I'm not sure of the extent of their nerf, how much they have been nerfed compared to in the past, but in the past they were totally OP, overpowered. Soviet Union. Our General Strukov.
Unsere Männer fliehen vom Schlachtfeld. Wir müssen sie sammeln.
Yeah. Yeah, they take down a tank with one hit. So they are kind of OP. So they took down all three of the light tanks there. The jeeps as well. Jesus Christ. Fallen heroes all. We lost our army, the rifleman. Heroic death, Captain Peter. Alright. So my units were defeated. SS troops are firing their assault rifles. Hard to see in this forest, yeah. Seems we are winning the battle, according to the statistics. Are they running away, maybe? The rocket trucks are still firing, though. The Soviet Union have proven to be kind of cowardly with their tanks. They often retreat if they are about to lose the battle, instead of actually fighting to the death. Yeah, they retreated. Their MS-1s and T-34s, even some trucks, but they still continue to fire while withdrawing their troops. And the infantry are also trying to leave, but they will probably be killed doing so. We have a few fighter planes left, a few tanks, motorcycles, etc. Took down some of their Katyusha rocket trucks here. Good job, soldiers. Still have one of the rockets here. It's broken. We have our BMW motorcycle unit there. Right, the statistics. 34% enemies killed, 6% allies killed. Some of those numbers are of course the retreated troops as well. Good that we won, though. We had mostly infantry, but also a lot of older armor. Panzer I's did a good job here. we could end it, but I don't believe it's at 85% yet. 52%, let's continue. Continue the battle. So we defeated both of their armies. Without letting them combine their forces. And I believe he won now. Yeah. We had two remaining out of our 13 riflemen. They fled the battlefield and then Gottfried Galen had 524 men, killed 0. Very bad. And have all of them remaining. They didn't enter battle, I see. Ernst Dissel with the great army had, because he had the mechanized stuff, Gottfried had probably only infantry and a Stokes mortar artillery unit. Alright, Ernst Dissel, 573 men, killed 367, pretty good, and have 522 left. And Georges Ruko had 617 men, killed 71, that was bad. And have 239 left, but they killed a lot of the tanks, so it's what's kind of good in that regard. Here's the detailed statistics screen. Let's hope it doesn't crash again. We entered this place here, but it might still crash at the ending of the loading screen. It's very annoying when that happens. It could crash when you start the battle and when you click on ending it and when this loading screen ends. Yeah, we managed to enter the map again. Man of the hour! We got a new general. Can't move. You don't need 2 units of riflemen. Elite or disband. Can't move the general. We have a new unit of general's bodyguard there with jeeps. Couldn't merge anything here. Let's move him down to the other force there. Alright, we can't move them. Could move those into the army too. And we have merged them, so we have a full army there. The rest will just, the rest of Gottfried Galen's army will just stand there. Can't do much more this turn. So we won the battles in this area. But they have more armies to send our way. And the armies we defeated did retreat. Maybe they will combine and come back. Riga is defended for now. We have 1 unit of riflemen in Riga currently. As for the army. Let's move another army towards the border there. Because the battle seems to be fought up in the Riga area. So we are sending Oscar Battle up there with mostly infantry army, but also some BMW motorcycles, Panzer Force, Dukas and artilleries. Remnants, but better than nothing. We need to protect the Riga area, because we are kind of protected by rebels here. So I think we are safe for now. At least this border area seems to be rebel still. I know this army is kinda bad, but at least it's a full army. Alright. Alright. Next turn. So we're rioting in Zagreb. That's not good. March troops there now. A full army in Vienna. So we could move something to Zagreb. Move the rifleman unit there. Suppress the revolt, but I'm not sure we can keep the city. They might revolt. Rioting in Zagreb. Betrayed. Hunger has betrayed us. Where are they attacking us? Hungary. They are attacking Prague. Held by Ferdinand von Bock. Ferdinand von Bock. Alright. This fucks. Alright. They are supposed to be an ally by this time. We will just force them back into an alliance.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a
show me how.
Left click on an item in the
map information.
Generous treaty proposal.
Ceasefire, trade rights. I'll do this to any allied faction that betrays me. At least if it's not historically accurate. Like for example, Bulgaria and Romania can betray me during 1943, I believe. But Hungary shouldn't betray me. Alright. Settlement besieges. Agent detected, Romania. End of turn report. We are minus 361 now. Not good. Faction announcements. Marriage celebrations. Gottfried Galen is married. Continue expands. Ferdinand Furbringer. Alright. Construction report. We have a lot of small parks in different cities. Yeah. Smaller parks. And then we have some units in different cities as well. Lots of assault infantry, some Stuka bombers, North Africa assault corps, Messerschmitt 109s. Yeah. Ceasefire in effect. The Third Reich, Hungary. Yeah, I forced that issue. Diplomatic information, the following factions are now at war with each other. So the British Commonwealth of Nations declared war on Hungary. French Republic declared war on Hungary as well. And the Romanians choose the side of Hungary when they betrayed me. Following factions have declared a ceasefire. The Nationalist Chinese faction or Chinese Republic have declared a ceasefire with the Japanese Empire. Right. Alright, the army, the fleet here will be moving towards the port at Heracleion. They will enter their next turn, while our other fleet will move to the port of Tunis. We will move the entire army of Erwin Rommel to the fleet, and it will try to move towards Athens. The Italians have a great fleet. No, just one unit there. I'm still worried that they will attack me or something. Alright. So we have brick wall here. We have cobblestone roads. Trader. Small concern. Loving the faction holding city to recruit North Africa assault corps if they are Germany. otherwise just assault infantry, but they have riflemen as well from the main building. They have hermelines and troopers from the port, and we have farms plus one. All right. What faction is that? The British Commonwealth of Nations. Bulgaria. I need to talk to the Italians, actually.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal.
Need your map information, and we will give you our map information, and we want you to help in the war against the Soviet Union. We already have that help, so we don't need that now. We will give you one region. We'll give you Tunis. It's up to you to hold Tunis now. We have evacuated our force there, and they got a defensive force here. Lots of riflemen. Worse infantry than we had, but still a good garrison. So Italy is now holding Tunis, but they seem to have lost Benghazi to the British. All right. Now they have, at least they have the capital. The area of Tripoli, and now they got Tunis as well. Right. We're counting on you to hold the area. But we can't control their armies, so no point trying to fight the United States, the British, and the Free French alone with worthless allies over there. We have 20 regions controlled now, so we've given two regions to Italy, and they managed to lose one already. We also lost a few regions to the Soviet Union. All right, and Erwin Rommel is now on board of the U-boat fleet, heading for Athens. We'll be there in two turns. Well, this fleet will be at Heracleion port in one turn, and we'll be able to move this force. Then we will give Heracleion to Turkey. Yeah. We need to evacuate this area before we can give it to Turkey. I don't see a point in holding that area. I want all my armies at the Eastern Front. Defeating the Soviet Union is the most important task for Germany. So the war should be fought entirely against the Soviet Union. Only defending against betrayals. But we will use the diplomats to keep the allies from doing anything. Alright. They can still cause trouble on the seas, but it's fine. This is a Hungarian diplomat. Alright. They also have an army on our lands, the Italians. And an army here. Right. So Africa has been entirely abandoned now. What about the Soviet Union? They didn't move any troops into our lands. So that's good. However, the Soviet Union did besiege Helsinki, the capital of the Finns. So Finland is now under siege by Pyotr Petro. Still move there. That's not good. It's their final settlement. You can see their army. So they have Lauri Christian Relander there. Faction leader, Lauri Christian Relander, their faction leader. Then they have Carlo Juho Stolberg, their faction heir, and Ingvar Neiminen, family member. So all of their leaders are here. If they lose Helsinki, they will lose the war. They also have two units of Messerschmitt 109 planes, same as we have. And they have some British Hurricane planes as well. So they got help from the British in the past during the 1939 Winter War, and they still have some of their planes. All right. And they have some captured T-34 Soviet tanks. They have a Panzer IV that they bought from Germany. And they have some assault infantry. They have unique Finnish infantry. It's not our infantry. It's slightly better. It's unique Finnish infantry. And then they have some German PAC-4 artillery and Stokes mortar artillery. They have some scout snipers and riflemen based on the German ones. They are as good as ours. And they have more assault infantry, unique Finnish infantry. Infantry. And then they have the two unique Molotov throwers. They throw Molotov cocktails against the enemy. They are like grenadiers, but they throw bottles instead. Pretty cool unit. So that's Finland. Alright. By the way, I'm not sure. They should have ski troopers as well. But in the campaign there aren't a lot of winter seasons, you know, 24 times per year, but there isn't winter half the year. It's probably only a fifth or a third or something. So it will be kind of odd to have ski troopers skiing in summer, which will be a case. But they are a really cool unit. However, they didn't have any in this army. I don't know if they can recruit them either. I know they have them in custom battle. I forgot to check that. Maybe they don't have them. If we're unlucky. Alright, so they are mostly infantry. Have some good planes and such. I believe their general's bodyguard is just jeeps. Yeah, jeep. Their second general is a jeep as well. I believe the third one is as well, yeah. So three jeep bodyguards. I fear Finland might actually be conquered by the Soviet Union this time. Because the Union has a lot of tanks. Yeah. Alright. So as for our arm here. Move this unit back. Let's move him back here. Alright. Do I have any new unit here? Nope, we didn't. Have an army too. We'll move it up there. Alright, so the second army is close to the other one now. And yeah. We abandoned Tunis as we said. Let's take a look at our agent. He's outside of Helsinki. And we have another diplomat, Ferdinand Kerbringer. He's at the Italian front. Need him to go back towards Turkey. So we want him to be in Istanbul next turn. And then we have Alfred von Kachler here. We want to talk to the Vichy French if we can. Spanish state here, we'll talk to them.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal.
So map information for both of them.
A balanced or very generous treaty proposal.
And they did send some troops against the Soviet Union, so yeah, we could want some help from the Spanish against the Soviet Union, actually. Even though they sent a legion under German command, but still. Let's do this. We got their map information now, so we have Spain on the map. Three areas that don't have, they didn't have Portugal. They know where the United States are too. We already knew about Alger, but now we have Casablanca here as well. And Spain has a fort as well. And the French, Free French have a fort there. Right. And they knew about Italy, so now we got, we already had Italy, I believe, when I think about it. Alright, but they had some witchy French areas too. French state witch, yeah. So the French are in our lands. Probably need this diplomat here to prevent the Hungarians from attacking again. To force them back. So their army had assault infantry, scout snipers, riflemen, another rifleman unit, BMW motorcycles, and riflemen. They are based on our troops, so they are just as good as our troops, including their motorcycles, but they have different textures, alright. They don't have as good an army as we have, but because they only have the early troops, but they are still a threat. So in war, so we have lots of infantry. Full army at Vienne. And another full army at Zagreb. Still they are revolting, which is kind of odd. Have a good force there as well. Let's move this army up towards Italy here. Scare them from attacking. Let's build some stuff. We're still building the medium park in Berlin. So let's see where we can build something new. We'll build some civil headquarters in Hamburg. In Frankfurt, could use a medium park as well. In Amsterdam, we will get a medium park. In Brussels, we will get some civil headquarters, I believe. And in Paris, farms plus 3. We could actually build that from the start. Alright, and then we'll get a medium park in Paris as well. In Rouen, we'll get a civil headquarters. Same in Bordeaux. Here clay and we won't get anything. Alright. I think we're done with recruitment. Let's go back to Berlin. Now it's time to recruit troops. We're still building some Stukas in Berlin. Yeah. Oslo will get another unit of assault infantry. And in Amsterdam we'll get another unit of... We'll get a new unit of Stukas there. In Brussels we'll use another unit of Messerschmitt 109s. Rouen we'll get another unit of Stuka bombers. Bordeaux will get Stuka bomber squadron. Herculean we could get another unit of assault infantry. Riga Yeah, we are still building there. Alright. And scout sniper unit in Zagreb could be good. Vienna, we could use some assault infantry. In Prague, we are still building some planes. Stettin, we are building planes there. And in Copenhagen, we'll get another unit of assault infantry. And we're back in Berlin. Alright, we're done here. Can't do anything this turn. We won't move outside of our borders. We are defending, not attacking currently. Alright. Next turn. The Soviets decided to attack. All our three forces are taking part in the battle. We have another army closing in behind them. But I believe these three will have to fight Alexander Petrov themselves. He has 768 troops. A large force. Some of the units have been in battle before. Alright. We will still fight this battle. I need to save the game. Because it is likely it could crash. Hope they won't retreat again. Let's start the battle. God damn it! You'll never get the purple heat hiding in a foxhole. Follow me, Captain Henry P. Jim Crow, 13th January 1943, Guadalcanal. God damn it! You'll never get the purple heart hiding in a foxhole. Follow me. Alright, start deployment. We have a general's bodyguard this time, a jeep. Alright, let's move him back, I believe. And loose formation, defense. Alright, start the battle. The entire army has arrived here. Soviet army. Alexander Petrov. Lots of infantry, some tanks, some Katyusha rockets, even some planes. Like 9 planes. We have a full army coming their way too. Scandinavian forces. Forces that conquered Scandinavia, Denmark, and Norway. Alright. Mostly infantry, but also a lot of armor and some fighter planes. And a Stokes mortar artillery unit. With at least 2 generals with jeeps. So they did attack this time, so I hope they won't retreat. They usually don't if they are the one attacking, but I might be wrong. The rockets are firing here. They're standing in the truck. So jeeps are over here. Our army is downhill, that's not good. Currently only the fighter planes have reached the enemy. Are firing upon them. I'll move my general back. Generals are kind of valuable, so I want to move him back faster. They don't attack my general. First thing they do. Better if they attack other stuff. Here is the AI control general. That's another matter entirely. If we lose this general, we have another one in the back that can replace his command of the army. They are firing their machine guns there, but are fired upon by the trucks. Rocket trucks. Another truck is here. They've broken the rifleman there. No, they are not broken yet. But they will break soon, I guess. Here we have the Stokes mortar artillery. Let's zoom in the minimap there. So the Stokes mortar is firing our artillery there in the battle. And the arm here is moving up the hill. Snipers laying down, firing. They can fire even though it's a mountain there. Alright. Lots of infantry in this army. One of our planes have been shot down. Nine planes are now attacking our snipers on the ground. Not taken down yet, but some plane did go down. Right. We have a jeep bodyguard, our jeep probably. Panzer Ones are firing. The enemy tank here took out their T-34s. Plane went down. We still have some Jack-9s there. At least three. They have lots of infantry. Some tanks still. Snipers are firing from a safe distance, while our infantry is still just marching around. Alright, their planes are firing upon my infantry. I'd like my planes to fight their planes, but they are busy fighting the tanks over here. These are my tanks, they have killed their tanks. They have other units here. And the deadly Katyusha rocket trucks here. They've taken out a lot of our fighter planes. So let's see how this will go. If they will retreat again or be killed. It's one or the other. I don't believe we will lose. Even though they have these deadly rockets here. Infantry is now running forward. Here are some Stokes mortars have retreated. Because they have tanks here that steamroll them. Another truck. They're driving over our snipers. Yeah, our infantry are kind of defenseless if the tanks and trucks reach them. Where is our armor? Matter if we have the numbers here. Our general probably try to take care of their trucks or something. I send my general against their tanks there. General himself, his full guard. The general car can't fire, by the way. It seems to only be the rest of the unit. Alright. Rocket trucks are firing upon our troops. They win it thanks to the rockets, I believe. We lost the general. Sven Jodl is dead. We lost the general. Now the rest of the bodyguard can fight to death. Doesn't matter. Three units routed. A lot of infantry still on the battlefield, including snipers. At least two units of snipers, maybe three. We have some broken infantry here, even though they are 70. Another general's bodyguard there. Maybe that's me. Yeah. Alright. Katyusha rockets firing upon our troops in the distance. Not good. Fear we only have infantry left. We are routing infantry here. Where are planes? Are they defeated already? Yeah, it looks like it. We have one plane here. Alright. Come on, Messerschmitt 109, take down their tanks. Ah, this is our tanks. Alright, we have some tanks there. They have better tanks. Their T-34s will probably win against our Panzers here, yeah. And they took down the plane too. Yeah. Or maybe not, I don't know. We have a lot of troops left that are not bad. We have mostly infantry left. We lost our Jeep. So yeah, Jeeps were very much nerfed. Shouldn't be better than tanks for one. They aren't anymore. Alright, they had a T-34 here. T-34 tank here. So we might be defeated. We have another army ready to reinforce the front, but it's mostly made up of infantry as well. So it's not good. Infantry and remnants. Not good, we are losing the battle. So the statistics, 47% allies killed, 24% enemies killed. Yeah, that's because they have mostly good stuff left, while we have only infantry left, I believe. That's why they will win. Even have planes, rockets and tanks left. We've lost all the armor and planes. The infantry won't be able to hold out, so the Scandinavian occupation forces have been defeated. Forces I sent from Oslo and Copenhagen to help in the Eastern Front. We have a Vesp artillery unit here, firing. Good. If the tanks reach it, it's over. or the rockets, the Katyusha trucks. This is a really good artillery unit. Better than the Stokes mortar and the Pack 40 artillery. Can take down both planes, tanks and rocket trucks, but the weakness is that it's driven by the crew. So if the tanks kill the crew, drive over the crew, it will just be abandoned. Unlike a tank, you don't need to destroy this unit, you just need to kill the crew. The range. It reached all over here. So their army is closing in on our remnants. Lots of planes still. Our infantry here is broken. The infantry troops are defeated. Crew is also retreating or regrouping. Not good. This will be a big defeat for us. We have another army ready to reinforce the front, but they have almost only infantry, so it won't hold out for long, unfortunately. A new army that is more mechanized. And we lost the battle. Clear defeat! So no one survived, nine survived actually, of Sven Jodl's riflemen. Alright, 72 out of 202 under Gottfried Gillen, and Ernst Dissel had 836 men and only 105 remained. The enemy army had 769 men and 584 remained, so it was a good battle for the enemy. Alexander Petrov's Soviet army also killed 851 of our troops. Now let's hope it won't crash, yeah. Here are the detailed statistics. Fuck, it crashed. We need to fight it again. So, we lost the battle. It crashed last time I played it again. Pretty much the same result. The army has been defeated. We have another army moving in here, but it's mostly infantry. So the remnant army with one of the three generals still alive, Gottfried Gillen, returned to the city. Alright. Move at least three infantry units back to Riga. Move out the Stokes mortars and the mechanized units there. Right. This army will try to fight. We'll try to fight again. Right, we'll fight the battle another time, but with the new army. The remnants will attack, but also new army under Oscar Battle. Mostly infantry too. Finland still is not defeated. Battle hasn't occurred yet. This army also had mostly remnants of mechanized troops. If they lose, Riga will fall, but they have two other great armies behind them. We have Alexander Ivanov here, and Dmitry Petrov. So they need to fight the battle again. We have some new Vesp artillery units here as well. Before we are going to fight that battle, we need to do other stuff. It's a new turn. Faction announcements. Heroic Death. Ernst Diesel died. And Svenjul. Yeah. Marriage celebrations. Evil Donuts. End of turn report, we are minus 6303, so it's not looking good. We lost a lot of areas. So. Agent detected Hungary, alright. Try to spy on us. Need a new army sent there. Planes here. Duke planes will board the ships there, and these Messerschmitts from Stettin, some Stukas from Berlin, they will board as well. Some more planes, they won't board, they will move by land from Prague. Full army in Vienna, but they need to defend against possible Italian betrayals. In Belgrade, they could also attack us there. Prague. Yeah. And what do we have in Warsaw? Lots of infantry. Let's move a unit of fighter planes to Riga to defend. Rest of the troops here could also move there. Infantry troops. See what we can move here. Italy is still holding Tunis. Our fleet won't reach Athens this turn. So Ernst Rommel, or Erwin Rommel. Is still on his way to Athens. Well, our transport ship reached the port of Heracleion this turn. We will move all the troops onto the ship. Alright. Troops over to that place. Lots of assault infantry here. Some scout snipers as well. And riflemen. So Athens is filled with infantry. Two units of riflemen there. reinforce it with this army for now. Under Gunter Alterbung. I believe he's historical. And we have a full army of infantry here with some mechanized units as well. Heraclion has been emptied. Let's talk to Turkey. Map information, they should have that. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is regions. Heraclion here. Not Paris. Heraclion. Alright, that's all. Anything else would be cheating. So Turkey is in control of the Greek isle of Heraclion here. They got a few riflemen units as a garrison as well. Turkey has control of that isle now. So things are going as planned there. I would like to replace infantry with actual mechanized stuff. Planes should be moved to the army. And the riflemen here, you don't need that. We can't move them because they were from the ships. We will replace them the next time with some assault infantry or snipers. For now we can't do that. Erwin Rommel's army is on his way as well. We're going to transmit troops. Need all the troops at the eastern front, but we need a mechanized army. The infantry will be like reinforcement filling the gaps. Alright. That plane will be needed in Belgrade for now, in case the Italians have any plans of betraying us. They would like to move some armies around. Hungarians are still in our lands, they might attack any time. Move out all the good stuff here. Right. All the mechanized units. Pretty good force there. We could move out one of them as well. And we could move out the other model, the general. The full army, mechanized army here. Let's move him towards the eastern front. So the infantry there, we don't need that. I believe he sent a plane here. It will need to join forces with this army. We needed this army at the front against the Soviet Union. So it has 5 units of Messerschmitt. Actually 6 units of Messerschmitt. That's really good. Messerschmitt 109s. And then they have 1 unit of anti-aircraft tracks. So a new unit is fielded on the battlefield. 1 unit of scout snipers. And it has 4 units of the worst type of tank, the Panzer 1. And it has a Stokes mortar and 3 units of BMW motorcycles. Alright. The strongest unit is the plane. Right, it has 1 unit of Stuka bombers as well and 1 Jeep bodyguard. That army is really needed against the Soviets, as they are breaking through here. I'm not sure we will win this battle, I think we will lose. And even if we would win, these armies will no doubt crush the remaining forces there. They will probably take Helsinki from Finland as well. Meaning we have lost the entire front here. We need more troops there. Some infantry sent here. And a plane, but we need more. An army is marching there. Alright, in the fleet here we had some troops. 3 plane units aborted the ship there. Here another army here. But it needs to become more mechanized, I believe. In Rommel we get the best army, and then we will give the second best to this guy, Gunter Alterbrung. And then the third army will not have any generals. Right. So we've given away our African areas and the Greek island here. And emptied Scandinavia. It's for Belgrade, capital of Yugoslavia. I'm not sure if we should give it to someone or not. Zagreb. Right, so in Belgrade we need the troops here to defend. In Zagreb we have a lot of infantry now and a Jeep bodyguard. Maybe not the best troops, but we need them there for now. In case they attack, we could use that unit there. Hamburg, we have 4 units of riflemen. Planes here. What do we have in München? München. Alright. Another army needs to move towards the eastern front. Another plane unit there as well. And here is another one. Don't reach this turn, but so we need 4 additional units there. We have 3 in the fleet there. So that means 1 additional unit is needed. I know we are weak in the front here. Towards Vichy, France. Move another sniper unit into Frankfurt. And a Stuka unit could be moved towards that army as well. Stokes mortar artillery could be moved there. And we need some strong forces against Portugal there, or Spain. So we have for some witchy French units there, riflemen. Alright. Let's move the fleet towards Riga. And let's build some stuff. Big park. Don't think we need that now. Or maybe we should do that. We will build the big park. Build the big park there, yes. Alright. Here we have a medium park in Athens. Let's build that as well. Maybe not, we don't need that if we're gonna give away Athens anyway. Let's retrain some troops though. Oh, they were already filled. Alright, let's build some Stuka bombers then. We're still constructing roads in Belgrade. We are building everywhere now. Let's see, recruitment in Berlin. Alright. Well, I think we could use a spy. Let's, but maybe we'll build recruit a spy from somewhere else. I think, for now we will build another anti-aircraft track. No, we won't do that. Another Stuka is better. And in Hamburg, we'll build some Messerschmitt 109s. In Oslo, some assault infantry. In München, some Stukas. Frankfurt, some Messerschmitt 109s. In Amsterdam we could actually, we are already building something there. In Paris, yeah, I think we could recruit a spy there. And in Riga could use some Stukas. Belgrade, we could use some Messerschmitt 109s, or no, we will need Stukas there. We already had, no, we already had Stuka. We will build a Messerschmitt 109 there. In Warsaw, we could use some Messerschmitts. In Vienna, we will get an assault infantry unit. In Prague, actually we could use some planes there, Stuka tactical bombers. In Stettin you'll also get some planes, fighter planes there. In Copenhagen we'll get another unit of assault infantry. And we're done. Now it's just time to fight that battle. I hope it won't crash again. I think the battles have started to crash way more often lately. Alright. Attack. Save the game. If it's CTD after the battle, or before the battle, I will take a pause now. Or I will finish this battle and save after. Yeah. And click next turn and at least do some more stuff. Alright, let's start the battle. We have only to kick in the door and the whole rotten structure will come crashing down. Adolf Hitler on the proposed invasion of the Soviet Union. start the deployment. We have a rifleman unit. We'll have it in loose formation and have guard mode on and just start the battle. We have larger forces, but they have probably stronger forces. We have mostly infantry. We are facing the same army as in the previous battle. We have some T-34s without turrets. First time I see that. Alright. Because they were damaged during the last battle. They have a strong force, including tanks, Yak-9 planes, and the deadly Katyusha rockets. Flags because our armies are still to enter the battlefield. Some of them at least. So we had quite the army, but mostly infantry. Broken Panzer Force there. Some jeeps. 2 units of Vesp artillery. Some BMW motorcycles. Even more infantry. They came from Brest, the Polish town, I believe. Only Polish town, besides the capital of Warsaw. Alright. Battle started. Our Stuka tactical bombers are bombing their troops, but will probably be taken down by their Yak-9 planes. Which isn't good. We had too few planes in the battle. Remnants from earlier armies that retreated to Brest. They will fight to the death against the army here. Ooh, didn't look good on the mountain there. Rest of the army is moving up the hills. So we have some jeep bodyguards there as well. Oscar something. 2 generals at least. Hope the damaged tanks get destroyed. I don't like them. We've taken out some of our planes here. Some of our Stukas. They have lots of fighter planes still. I believe they've taken down all of our Stukas. Already scared away this unit, our unit of riflemen. It's running away. Yeah. We really need new armies on this front because infantry armies can't hold. No matter the numbers. They're like cannon fodder. I am thinking that they will win the battle due to their better units. Even though our army hadn't seen battle before, with the exception of our good units, they had seen battle. also have a lot of infantry. Scare away the SS infantry there. Our riflemen are running up. There's some more of an SS there. They are not that bad. The rest of the infantry is alright. Snipers are pretty good too, if you have that. I'm not sure if I had any snipers. Maybe one unit or two. Yeah, the battle isn't going our way. Look at the statistics. 35% allies killed, 8% enemies killed, so it didn't go well. I didn't think it would, because of the majority of infantry. Still, they can hold the line for a while. Until our reinforcements arrive. I wonder if Soviet will be able to conquer Riga before we can get our armies up to Riga. We may be able to actually take the city before we reach it. Moving the front towards Brest and Stettin, I believe, or Warsaw. We have a few jeeps still alive here. Undestroyed. All our infantry troops here. Useless. They must be thinking that we have nothing left of quality anymore. That the only thing we have left are infantry. And that the victory is certain. Would be surprised if the game didn't crash after the battle. So you need to play it at least once, I guess. Riflemen are hunting our retreating troops. Their Yak 9 planes are firing at them. The tanks are moving forward as well. Yeah, we had some scout snipers. They didn't help much. The entire army is beaten.
Unsere Verbündeten fliehen vom Schlachtfeld. Welch grimmiger Tag für das Reich.
Yes, this was a catastrophe.
Die Niederlage hinterlässt einen bitteren Nachgeschmack im Munde aller Krieger des Reiches.
Clear defeat. Captain Heinrich, men deployed 8-1. Killed one and lost 28. The rest fled. Oscar Battle, 814 men. 106 kills, that was really bad. But that's to be expected by an infantry-only army. It's only a few other units. Men remaining 168, really bad. Catastrophe. Gottfried Gehlen, 456 men. One kills, that was really bad. 91 left. Alexander Petro, 927 men. Killed 1,057 of our army. Alright. And 825 men, this was really good for him. And the detailed stat stick. continue. Might still crash after this. In the event of any action which clearly threatened Polish independence and which the Polish government accordingly considered it vital to resist with their national forces, His Majesty's government would feel themselves bound at once to lend the Polish government all support in their power. Neville Chamberlain, 31st March 1939. No, it crashed. You have to fight it